Hello, everybody. Welcome to Smoking Cigars with Howlin' Blind Muddy Slim. That's me, Howlin' Blind Muddy Slim, with all due respect to Gary Burbank. I want to show you a few nice things today. October the 17th. I just got in. This is for my birthday. That is an Orville Les Paul Cherry Red, and I am excited about that. Also, yesterday was my granddaughter Trinity's birthday, and I got to spend the evening with my granddaughter at her birthday party, plus my grandson Logan, who is Dolph 87's son. Let's see what else. I was going to smoke this. I want you to see it. That is a Fuente. I hope you can see it. Between the Lines. And if you know anything about cigars, you know what that is. Now, I was going to smoke it. I got it yesterday. Don't ask me where I got it. Don't ask me how much it cost, or who I got it from, or how I got it. Just know I got it. I'm not going to smoke that cigar today. Don't ask me how much I paid for it. It was a very, very small amount. But I went online last night, saw places that were selling for as little as $17, if they had them, and as much as $42, if they had them. Nobody has them. I got one. The last one I saw that I actually owned and smoked was in 1999 for the holiday season, and I smoked it New Year's Eve going from 1999 to 2000, I think, or it might have been even Thanksgiving of 1999. Let me light up this Hoyt & Monterey Excalibur 1066 Dark Knight. It's a good cigar. Life is good, folks. Despite the debates, and what I was going to do with the Fuente Between the Lines, I want to show you that again. I'm going to put it back in the humidor in a moment. I was going to say, you know, no politics. I was going to say even George Bush, read between the lines. I wasn't even going to do that joke. But anyway, despite the debates, despite the fact that we've got all these problems going on in our country, life is good. My band Blue Sound is playing quite a few places. And my granddaughter Trinity celebrated her first birthday last night. Had a great time. And I may do a video of some of her pictures and some of my grandson, Logan, some of his pictures to probably one of my favorite songs. I got my Les Paul Orville. That makes three, folks. I got a Black Custom, a Cherry Sunburst Standard, which is a killer guitar. I mean, it's like a 1959 Gibson. But life is good. Gas is down in Fairdale, Kentucky, around $2.60-something a gallon. The bailout hasn't gone through yet. And we still got two jerks on TV lashing out at each other like a fake wrestling match. John McCain and Barack Obama. You ever stop to think, what if politics were a wrestling match? We know wrestling is fake. I used to watch it as a kid. know, Jerry Lawler and Tojo Yamamoto, Jeff Jarrett, all those guys, long before Vince McMahon came along and ruined wrestling. And, but we know now that wrestling is fake. It's a script that big bad on the good guy side and big bad on the bad guy side get together. They work out their routines. They know exactly what's going to happen. The only time they really get ticked off is when one of them doesn't do the move the way they were supposed to. And that's the only time anybody gets hurt or pissed off. Politics, when I watch Barack Obama and John McCain, it's like a fake wrestling match. I'm sure backstage they have got things worked out exactly how they're going to say it, how they're going to insult each other. And they get on stage and they insult each other, but they shake hands and they probably go out to dinner at night saying, "We have really fooled the American people." Both of these guys, America, let's try something. On election day, nobody vote. Bush wouldn't stay in office because I think there's some rule in Congress that says a president can't serve more than two terms unless maybe that he declares martial law, which is what I predicted Bush would probably do anyway, but who knows. But here's the bottom line. Politics is crooked as hell. Politicians are crooked as hell. John McCain is a crook. Barack Obama's a crook. Sarah Palin's a freaking idiot. Maybe I shouldn't say that. Maybe I shouldn't say Sarah Palin's an idiot. She's ignorant. She hasn't been updated or briefed on the things that she needs to know to take over when John McCain has a heart attack in office and she has to take over. And I don't, and I'm not saying this on a bad side, but if Barack Obama wins and he gets assassinated, which I pray to God doesn't happen, because that would be so, that would be devastating for America. It would. But the only man qualified, in my opinion, to run the country is Joe Biden. And we know Joe Biden won't get the presidency because I don't think he would stoop as low as you got to stoop to be president. I mean, you've got to promise an awful lot of people an awful lot of things. But bottom line, life is good. Got my fuente between the lines. I can't wait to smoke that thing. But I mean, I'm talking about $42. It may be valued at $50. And I think that's the one. That's one that came out in 1999, because of where I got it. Can't tell you. Can't tell you how much I paid for it. But it got horrible. I'm sitting back smoking cigars. So far, it's still free to do that. And my granddaughter had her birthday. Life is good. So, light up, have a cigar, relax, enjoy gas at 260 something a gallon, because if it's not there yet, it'll hit that in your area. And let's hope the bailout never goes through. Maybe gas will get down to $1 a gallon. Houses are coming down. On the bad side, a person with a $300,000 home couldn't sell it for $150,000 now. But on the good side, a person who's looking for a $300,000 home could buy one for $150,000. So, I think it'll all work out if we just sit back and not participate in the political system. We don't vote for anybody because Ron Paul is not running. And let's upset their apple cart. Nobody vote. This has been Smoking Cigars with Hal and Blind. I've got another video I'm going to do in a few minutes, but it'll be up here. It'll be separate. So everybody, ciao, and we'll talk to you later.